परम सुखदम् केवलम् ज्ञानमूर्तिम् द्वन्द्वातीतम् गगनसदृशम् तत्त्वमस्यादिलक्ष्यम् एकम् नित्यम् विमलमचलम् सर्वदी साक्षिभूतम् भावातीतम् त्रिगुणरहितम् सद्गुरुम् तम् नमामि.
Nithyanandam, we welcome all the Sri Mahants, Mahants, Kotaris, Tanedars, Balasanths, visitors and viewers for this Vakyartha Sadhas conducted by Balasanths of Nithyananda Gurukul. Today's topic for Vakyartha Sadhas is today's satsang. And now we'll be chanting the 14th verse of the Ishavasya Upanishad.
Sambhutim cha vinasham cha yastadvedo bhayagum saha विनाशेन मृत्युं तीर्त्वा सम्भूत्य मृतमश्नुते.
I have a question. What is the meaning of looking at life with a larger vision? What I feel is looking at life with a larger vision. Before doing any action, whether when you see whether it's going to lead you to completion or not, analyzing whether the action you're going to do is it going to expand you or shrink you, and considering everything after that, the after effects, side effects, consider everything, and only if everything is going to lead you to a space of completion, doing the action is what I feel as looking at life with a larger vision.
What I feel is looking at life with a larger vision is when you start not just like fulfilling a temporary gratification, but when you wait and look at the purpose of your life and align all your actions towards the purpose of your life.
What I feel is looking at life with a larger vision is knowing that you are not just this body which is going to be for 25 years and 30 years, and not having pleasures just based on the body and all that, and just thinking about body and all that, but knowing that you are the consciousness and that you are eternal, and working your whole life, your whole pleasure and everything, pain, everything based only on that.
You're just adding a point. What I feel is, it's like basically you seeing and doing what you want to do at that particular time. It's like when you're doing something, why you're doing what you're doing, you have to see. Because when you know that you're doing something which only fulfills whatever you wanted at that particular time, will not expand you at all. But when you have that context that you're going to enrich the whole world or some higher purpose which you have, at that particular time when you're doing with that particular context, that means that you're having a larger vision of your life, because you are actually doing each of your actions based on what you're going to achieve in your life.
I have a question. What is agitation gratification?
What I feel is agitation gratification is when we do not see the big picture of life, when we just see that situation and try to find a solution for it. When we do not consider the like side effects or after effects or what it's going to take for us to do, or when we don't even think that whether it's going to bring us to completion or not, just because the situation is there, just for a solution, you just do something. You do an action which is going to gratify that agitation you're feeling. Is what I feel as agitation gratification.
Just adding a point, like how Swamiji said about agitation or gratification, it might give you like temporary happiness at that moment, but as you continue on and on, go on and on with your life, it just won't give you that fulfillment and that bliss. Because once you start doing that again and again, you'll just get into more tiredness and boredom, because at one point you'll just get tired and bored of it. So it'll actually lead us to more and more incompletion.
What I think is agitation gratification is a goal that we set, looking at the shorter vision of life, and just basically the gratification which brings us only agitation. So what I think is that agitation gratification only gives us temporary happiness.
What I understand as agitation gratification is that like whenever, like because of the lower inner image you have, and because of having the lower inner image, you go on having like all the ideas about pleasure, pain, everything will be like very low only. So automatically whenever you like some few things which just agitates you, then automatically you'll feel full, you'll think that oh, you're feeling happy, and you'll just feel fulfilled just for that. So what if, but it'll not be like permanent happiness at all. So what I feel is that when such happiness, whenever you think that you're happy at that point, that's what I feel as agitation and gratification.
I have a question. How can we start moving from agitation gratification to delay gratification?
What I feel is when you decide to go on a satsanga, the space around you will help you in living the delayed gratification.
But even whether you have like a satsanga or the space around you, it's all based on your decision only, right? Without your decision, how can you even align back just by having a satsanga around you?
What I feel is that satsanga is very strong enough. See, even if you come to satsanga, you come only because you want to transform. And because of that decision itself, the satsanga around you will surely push you to making you authentic and making you be in delayed gratification.
Adding to his point, what I also feel is that only when you decide that you want to transform in your life, the satsanga even happens around you. Till then, it will just be the dusanga which you are continuously in. As Swamiji told, when you start living these truths and just decide to even live these truths, you will see, you will move on to the next level itself. And you will see that people around you are in the next level. So what I feel is even the satsanga happens around you because you decide to.
Just adding a point, what I feel is when we start living around a satsanga, when we see others being in a delayed gratification and start moving to more and more completion, we will feel so inspired to live the delayed gratification and completion that we will just set the context and just jump into the delayed gratification and live as enlightened beings.
Just adding to his point, as Swamiji told in your past birth, you already gave a miscall to Mahadeva. So that decision made you to transform and you came to a satsanga.
Adding a point, what else I feel is, like one day Swamiji came to Gurukul and he was telling us about this delayed gratification, and then he gave all of us the chocolates. He told the mentors to distribute the chocolates for all of us, and then he told, he wants to see the delayed gratification in Gurukul. So when the chocolate was given to all of us, all the kids just took one, each one took one, and then we all shared with each other. At last we didn't fight if you see in outer world schools, the moment that anything is distributed like this, we just go fight with everybody, bully each other. That's how we do, but that's how they do. But then here we didn't do that. We were like completely in the space of Advaita. We shared with each other, and then we had the delayed gratification. If at all we had the agitation gratification, we would have just be temporarily happy. But because we had the space of Advaita and shared with each other, we had the permanent happiness, which is Advaita.
Just adding to a point, there was an experiment which happened where the parents actually keep one chocolate for the kid and tell them to wait for an hour till the parents come, and then only they'll be able to get the chocolate and more chocolates as well. But there are a few kids who ate the chocolate before even the parents came, and there are a few people who ate the chocolate when the parents came. So if you see in these both cases, the kids who waited, if they analyzed their life and they found that they actually achieved lots of things and they were successful in their life, and the kids who didn't wait for the parents to come and they ate the chocolate, they had more problems in their life and like difficult to face their life. So if you see, the kids who had delayed gratification in their life had the thing of listening, and they had the thing of even achieving lots of things in their life also. But the people who actually had the agitation gratification, where they ate the chocolate just for the satisfaction at that particular time, just to satisfy their greed, had so much of problem in their life. So when you're moving to agitational gratification, to the delayed gratification, you will be able to achieve in your life and be successful in your life.
So does that mean delayed gratification is patience? Like what I understood when, like in both examples, is like all of them were like patient only. So does that mean delayed gratification and patience are one and the same?
What I feel is that delayed gratification is not just about patience. It is about knowing that you are eternal, you are going to live for such a long time, and you know that your consciousness, why waste life in simply all this junk food and all this shopping mall and all that, but instead live the consciousness, live in seeking and all that. So I feel that is what is delayed gratification, where you are, what you think about life, what you feel about life, whatever you want from life, all that is such a high desire and high cognition.
Seeing the example like what Madhipa gave, it was like one experiment conducted where there is just a chocolate given to the kid. So like the kids who ate first itself before their parents coming, so you told that it was agitated gratification. Whereas if you see in the other case where the kid waited and after the mother coming, the kid ate the chocolate, there you told it's delayed gratification, right? But even there, the kid is just eating the chocolate. So what did you exactly mean by this example?
What I feel is, even though in both cases in the end the kid ate the chocolate, the first case where the kid, you know, like did not wait for his mother and just ate the chocolate before her mother coming, he was not able to see the bigger picture of life. He just saw that situation. He did not realize, oh, when the mother comes back, she told me to wait and eat the chocolate. She must have some reason behind it. I must find her and then eat. He did not think like that. He just saw, oh, the situation, I want the chocolate. So without analyzing, he just ate the chocolate. But the other kid who waited and ate when after his mother coming, you know, he learned to have delay gratification. He had the sense that, oh, why did my mother tell me not to eat the chocolate now? Maybe there's some context behind it. And then he would have found it out and then eaten. This is what I feel as a, you know, like what the example actually meant.
But I don't understand how are they both not same, because in both the cases you're still waiting, having the patience. In patience also, like you're waiting for the other person, and even in delayed gratification you're waiting, right? So what's the difference actually?
What I feel is delayed gratification is not just in the action level but also in the thought level. It is like the thought pattern which you're going to use all your life. Like when you're small itself, like when you start having delayed gratification, you use the thought pattern as like your root thought pattern, and the root thought pattern helps you all your life in making big decisions. So not just about the action like patience, but that is like a root thought pattern which helps you all your life.
Just adding to his point, what I feel is, in the first case, the children didn't wait. He just ate the chocolate and had a temporary happiness. But in the second case, the child waited for the parents to come. And so, and he had the fulfillment for more longer time. So he saw the big picture of the whole thing, and then that is what I feel is the difference.
I have a question to what Tattva Maharaj said. He was telling that the delayed gratification is in the thought level. Is it so that even the patience is not is in the thought level? Because you will even be patient with somebody or someone only in the thought level if you're compassionate to them. For example, a mother, she'll be patient with a kid only in the thought level because she's loving the kid, right? Why will anybody be patient without, like, it's related to thought current, right?
What do you feel is that, like, patience is just like one of the side effects of delayed gratification. When you have delayed gratification as your whole thought current, then automatically you will be patient and you will be caring. So whereas like at some points the context from which you do depends. At some point you'll not even bother about the other person, but just for the sake of like showing you as though you're sympathetic and all, you might act as your patient. Even like I've seen so many people who are irritated with other people but just acting as though they're patient, but that's not real patience. Whereas if you see, like, when you have the delayed gratification as a context, and when the patience comes out of that, then automatically it will come with that responsibilism, and like you'll automatically complete the other person. So what I feel is that the patience which comes out of the delayed gratification is totally different from that, like, just acting as your patient.
But I have a question, like in the example Lopamudra gave, when you're just acting to be patient but you're actually not patient, that's not even patience, right? So what is the real difference?
First of all, what do you exactly mean by patience here?
What I feel is patience is just when you're waiting for something. I don't think patience necessarily has to be from completion, but like delayed gratification is from completion, when you're waiting for something to happen and you're in completion. But patience is just when you're waiting for something.
So like based on what you tell, like it's just in the action level only. Whereas delayed gratification is not just in the action level, it's the thought current level. So when you have the delayed gratification, automatically side effect will be that patience.
See, if you listen to your own words, you're contradicting your own statements. First statement, you're telling that how can it be patient if you're not just waiting? And second statement, you're saying it's just waiting, there is only patience. So yourself understand, see, patience is from, it will be from completion, because you need completion to wait for the other person. Not even like, as you told, it's just a side effect of a delayed gratification.
Just adding to a point, what I feel is, when we are incomplete, no, and we try to be patient, that will not be real patience. We are just trying to be patient, we are acting as we are patient. But when we have a context and when completion, that is the time when we express the real patience. We will understand the other person is a part of us and we will actually be patient with them. But when you are in incompletion, we will just think like, oh, only if I be in patience, he is going to listen to me. Only if I be patient with him, he will speak with me and I can get what I want. What I feel is, out of incompletion, the patience start turning away from cunningness. This is what I feel is the difference between both.
I have a question. You told that patience is, when you have delayed gratification, patience will come as a side effect. But when you are in the delayed gratification, you will know that you are the consciousness and you have to reach the space. So it will be an intense seeking. And in seeking, how are you being in the space of patience? Because it will be like, I want enlightenment, I want enlightenment. You'll be like in that space, you want consciousness, you want to be in that high space. So how will you have patience that time?
What I feel is, if you're in the deep seeking, you will have the patience, because you're waiting for the enlightenment to happen to you, right? That itself is your patience. Completely, because you're completely into what Swamiji wants you to be. So you're patient enough to work, like live those truths and get that into you.
Just adding to a point, what I feel is, when we are in intense seeking, that time we'll be very patient with others to find out what incompletion they have. Because many times people may not be ready to tell us the incompletion they have with us. At that point, what I feel is, if you're not in seeking, it'll become like, we'll start thinking, oh, he's not ready to tell me the incompletion, I'll just move on, I don't care about him. We'll just leave the person and go. But when in seeking, what I feel is, we'll care for each and every person. So be patient with everyone to understand the incompletion they have and complete everything.
I have a question about what Master Timai told. You told that we should have delayed gratification towards enlightenment. But why should you even wait for enlightenment? If enlightenment comes, you just like attain it, right?
Like how Swamiji told, like only when you have the delayed gratification, you will be in the space of grasping. Otherwise, like whatever truth is presented to you, whatever is given to you, if you feel that it's not working for you, you'll just stop living it at all. And you'll never look in and try to find out what, like, where do you exactly miss out living the truth. So what I feel is that only when you have the delayed gratification, you'll even listen to what your master tells and even think of living it and start living it. Otherwise, when you're just like in that agitational gratification, like however you want, you'll just do something and you'll just, if something was working for you, you'll just stop doing it. This is what I feel, this is how I feel that delayed gratification is important for enlightenment.
But I have a question about Lopamudra at all, because in satsang Swami says we need the urgency to get enlightened. So is that the same as patience?
What I feel is that the urgency needs to be there in us. That always meaning, that doesn't mean that you will be like worried about not being enlightened. Because when you're only when you're complete and when you have that urgency to get enlightenment, then automatically you look forward for like how well you can transform and align yourself back to like how Swamiji tells us to be. But if you're in that agitational gratification, then you'll be like, you'll just try something, and if it doesn't work for you, that's all. Oh, this doesn't work for me. So how can, you'll just start worrying. You'll not even have the trust on enlightenment. Only when you're having that trust and the delayed gratification, you'll even have that urgency to be enlightened. Otherwise, all that you'll be having as urgency will just be that worry only.
Adding to her point, what I feel is urgency of enlightenment is continuously seeking and questioning the cosmos if any problem comes. Questioning the whole cosmos and non-stop seeking is what I feel is urgency for enlightenment.
I have a question on what Lokamudra said. How can something like the Swamiji's truths, just when you try it, you'll be like worrying about it? For example, the Nithyananda way of thinking as Swamiji told. You just completely depend on Swamiji, and how will you ever lose the trust? Because Swamiji does it to you. I have experienced in my own life, when you just do something out of Nithyananda way of cognition, it will happen to you. So what do you mean out of agitation, gratification, living Swamiji's truths and worrying about it?
like how Swamiji told us a story, like where there'll be a enlightened being who'll be like walking on the water, and there'll be another common man who'll be standing there, and he'll see this master walking on the water. So he'll tell, "Oh master, even I also want to walk on the water." So the master will tell, okay, just chant the Lord's name and start walking. So moment he'll go near the water, he'll just lift his dhoti and start chanting Shiva's name. So at that time again he gets into the water only. This is because he doesn't have that trust inside him. What I feel is that for anything to happen, you need to have the trust. That's why Swamiji told, even when he gives the gift of Shiva home experience, we'll experience it. But somehow, because like we somehow start giving different reasons, telling, "Oh, I didn't have this experience, I'll not have that experience," and somehow try to deny it at all. So what I feel is that only when you have that trust, you'll be able to experience it and hold on to that experience.
If your statements are gullible at all, that urgency, when you have that, you'll be having the urgency and delayed gratification. I really didn't understand how is it that urgency and delayed gratification are same.
What I feel is that, like Swamiji, when he did so much of tapas and everything, he was in the daily gratification. He knew that his life is so long, so huge, that he is the consciousness, and he knew that he had to quickly get it so that he can start enriching the whole world and make them also be in the space of consciousness. So based on that, he did so much of intense tapas and everything, and it became so urgent in him that finally the enlightenment happened in him. So because the delayed gratification he had in him, he knew that he is the cosmos, he is the consciousness, so he wants to experience that in him and enrich the whole world with that. So that created the urgency in him to become enlightened and make all of us also be like him.
I have a question about what Moksha Maharaj just told. He told, like in Swamiji's own life or anyone's life, when we have the cognition that we have thousands of years ahead of us, we're eternal and all that, then how will we even get that urgency to get enlightened? We'll think we have so much of time, let it go, right?
Yes, but you'll not want to waste thousands of births to get enlightened. You'll be thinking, why not get enlightened now itself and enlist the whole world to also be in the space of enlightenment. You'll not be thinking about postponing and there's so much of time, why not let's just wait and waste life. You'll not be thinking like that.
What I feel is that, like, when you know, like, you have to, like, when you know that your whole life is just eternal, then automatically the truth will just inspire you more and more. You'll never get that cognition of postponing things. Like how Swamiji told, like, when you just, if you want to do something, just declare that until my so-called death, I will continue to desire for life. So when you just start cognizing it like that, then automatically you'll get the cognition, why to waste time until my death and all. Let me start now itself. So you'll not postpone, you'll just start living the truth. So what I feel is that when you just know that you are eternal, then automatically you will start desiring for life and you will start living the truth. You'll never get the idea of postponing.
What I think is that when we have delayed gratification, we'll just, like what Lobamudra said, we'll just understand that it's never late to do something, that we're just eternal and we have so much time to do everything. So what I think is that when we understand, when we have this delayed gratification, we'll have the urgency to do everything. Basically, what I think is urgency in this case is just having that strong intention and just saying yes to life for everything that we do. So what I think is that when we have delayed gratification, we'll have the urgency to do everything in our lives.
I have a question on what Parameshwari told. She just told that it's never too late to do anything, right? So if it's never too late, then you'll have the postponing pattern only, that you keep postponing to get the enlightenment or anything. You'll not have the urgency, right?
What I feel is, when we start understanding that it's never too late to start like any completion or anything, we start understanding that, oh, even though these period days I've been wasting my life, it's still not too late. So let me just start now itself and finish as fast as possible. So immediately you start living the enlightened Nithyananda way of cognition, and you'll start, you know, like enriching the whole world and get enlightened, what I feel.
Just adding a point, if you see in the life of Angulimala itself, even if he did lots of bad sins and like didn't follow what he was going against life, when Buddha gave the experience to him, he was like, he never thought that, oh, I did all this stuff, So it takes for me to clean all this and clear up all my karmas and all that, then only I can get enlightened. He thought that it's never too late for him to do something. Even if he did all that, it's time. There is a possibility for him to even reinvent himself and recreate and do what he wanted to do, what his purpose for. So when there is a possibility given to you, there's nothing late for you to do something. You'll automatically have that feeling that you will be able to reinvent and recreate now at least, and go with the purpose of your life.
But in the example what Madhipa gave, what is there? What is delayed gratification in that? He understood that he is not going to postpone and he is going to enter into his possibility, which is like the initiation from Buddha. But what is the delayed gratification in what he said?
What I feel is, when Angulimala decided to start following Buddha and become his disciple, what I feel is at that point Angulimala saw the bigger picture of life. He understood that Buddha was enlightened and he can lead him also in the same space. What I feel is Angulimala knew that what he was doing is not right, but he still had to do it. Because his guru asked for the mala of 1,000 thumbs, he constantly kept on doing it. And he just started doing so many sins. But when he realized that the way of Buddha was a better way of living, and Buddha could take him into the space, what if it is that point Angulimala looked into the bigger picture of life? He understood that being a disciple of Buddha, he also can become a Buddha. So what I feel is, at that point when Angulimala decided to look at the bigger picture of life, he was in delayed gratification.
I still really didn't understand what is really delayed gratification. Is it just you seeing the larger vision of life and understanding things, like how you guys are giving example now? Or is it just having the patience to wait? I'm not really getting that what exactly is delayed gratification.
See, as you told, when you just see the larger vision of your life, when you have the matured cognition about yourself, then automatically all the understandings you have about life, others, everything will be taught, matured. So because of that, you'll have that patience automatically. You'll never be in that, hurry-worry and doing things and all. You'll never have that tension in you. You'll have patience also. And at the same time, you'll have the right context to do anything, because you know that you're eternal and you'll be having that matured cognition about yourself and life. So this is what I understand as delayed gratification.
What I feel is you having a larger having a cognition that your consciousness is what I feel is larger cognition of life, which is delayed gratification.
What I feel is delayed gratification is looking at a bigger picture of life. When we start seeing the bigger picture of life and start understanding everything, what I feel is naturally patience will come as a side effect. We will we'll understand that our life is eternal. It's not just 2500 years supposed to live. We have the eternal life. So what I feel is patience also naturally just fall as a side effect.
What I feel is patience is not the same as delayed gratification, because in patience you can also be incompletely patient. Like for example, in the chocolate example, in that the child can even be incomplete, see they're doing this to me, they're making me wait. So he'll be actually incomplete at that time because he's not getting the chocolate. But in delayed gratification, you understand that you are consciousness, and from that cognition you wait. So it's not exactly patience.
Adding to his point, what I also feel is that the delayed gratification comes, and then you'll understand that life is not just about just wasting time around and not going to having junk food and all the stuff and watching movies and being with friends and all that. It is something more. It is about enlightenment. It's about being in the space of consciousness. So when you understand that, then you'll not be sitting patiently and all that. You'll be in the urgency to be enlightened. You'll be in the urgency to I should get awakened. I should become awakened. So that time you'll not be in patience. What I feel is patience is something which is not related to delayed gratification.
What I feel is that patience of completion is the side effect of delayed gratification. Because when you're having the delayed gratification, you'll never be impatient at all. Yes, the urgency will be there. That doesn't mean that you'll be incomplete and give up on things and all. You will be patient and you'll be having the delayed gratification inside you. So what I feel is that when you're having the delayed gratification, that patience will be out of completion space.
Just adding a point, what I also understood is that having the urgency with the right context is great gratification. Like suppose you feel, I want chocolate, but out of desperation if you feel that, then that's just patience because you're doing it out of incompletion. But when you have the right context with that, for enlightenment, like how we discussed. So when you have the urgency to reinvent ourselves with the right context, I feel it's delayed gratification.
I have a question. What is this patience which is coming from completion and which comes from incompletion? And how can you change patience which, whether will it come from completion or incompletion?
What I feel is, when we know that everyone's a part of us and we are a part of everybody, and from that cognition we have patience. When we know that person is a part of us, so we have to wait for them and we have patience after that. From that context and that cognition, I feel that's the patience coming from the completion. But if you just think that only if I be patient, the person can listen to me and I can get what I want, that's what I feel is patience coming from incompletion. And what I feel is, when we just set the context that we are a part of everything, we are not anything around us, the consciousness, and we are a part of everything and everything is a part of us, before doing any action, what I feel is we can move from this space of incomplete patience to complete patience.
I have a question. How will delayed gratification awaken our seeking?
What I feel is, as we just discussed now, when you have the delayed gratification, you'll understand that your consciousness, then you'll know the larger vision of your life. So when you know that, obviously we will have the urgency to get enlightenment and enrich the whole world, as how Swamiji is doing now. So what I feel is, automatically when you have the urgency, that is what Swamiji calls us as seeking. Where when you have the urgency, you will try changing everything around you and your taste will get mature. So what I feel is, that is the awakening, the seeking in you. So obviously it awakens the seeking in you.
What I think is that when we have delayed gratification, like what Masatame has said, we'll have the urgency to do everything. So what I think is that we'll have the right context and we'll always be saying yes to life. So what I think is that when we're always saying yes to life, naturally we'll be seeking.
With this, we come to the conclusion of today's Vaakyartha Sadhas. We'll explore into more deeper truths and further Vaakyartha Sadhas. Now we'll conclude the Purna Mantra.
Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Harihi Om Tat Sat Sarvam Sadguru Padukarpanamastu Om Nithyanandam.